Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. Today's video is going to be about the hospitals in the UK and how to choose the right one for you as a doctor or a healthcare professional. I made a video recently on how to choose a good hospital. I will leave a link to it down below. In that video, I mentioned that the best way to choose a good hospital is to speak to someone who is working there, or to do a couple of locum shifts there to check out the hospital for yourself. However, I understand that it might not be feasible, especially if you are a new doctor or if you are an international doctor who is coming to work here for the first time. This video will hopefully give you an alternative way on how you can compare and choose a good hospital to work in. This is based on the hospital or the Trust Care Quality Commission or CQC ratings. Generally, if the trust or the hospital has consistently had good or outstanding ratings from the CQC, it will be a good place to work and to train. I have worked in 7 different hospitals so far, and all the hospitals that I've liked working in have had a good CQC rating, and the ones that I did not like working in had poor CQC ratings. All hospitals in the UK, NHS and private hospitals, are rated and checked by the Care Quality Commission or CQC. This is done almost every year to ensure that the hospital is providing a good service to the public. The CQC is an independent public body, part of the Department of Health in the UK. It is there to regulate and inspect health and social care services in the UK. You can find the latest CQC ratings and the full report on all hospitals and even GP practices online. I will leave a link to their website down below. Hospitals are rated based on the specific services that they provide, including medical care, children's services, maternity, emergency services, critical care, and surgery. These are assessed individually, and using this, the hospital is given an overall rating. There are essentially 5 domains being assessed: whether the hospital is safe, caring, effective, responsive to people's needs, and well-led. There are 4 ratings that are given to hospitals: outstanding, good, requires improvement, or inadequate. Based on the CQC rating, the hospital will normally make necessary changes in order to improve its service and ensure that it is performing at high standards. Even very well-established tertiary centres can receive a negative rating. For example, Edinburgh's Hospital in Cambridge received a CQC rating of inadequate in 2015. The hospital made loads of improvements and now it is doing very well. I think the most recent CQC rating was good. The CQC will also report on staffing levels of the hospital, whether the hospital is well staffed or not. So do spend some time and read the full report. Generally, you really want to be working in a hospital that is well staffed. In hospitals that are understaffed, one doctor will be doing the work of 2 to 3 doctors, or one nurse will be doing the work of 2 to 3 nurses, or 2 to 3 nursing assistants. This is very common in the NHS, so do make sure that you choose a hospital that is well staffed. Before I end this video, I thought I'll read part of an actual CQC report. Medical staffing in ED and eye casualty fell short of requirements, and this impacted patient safety and timely care. We found some shifts in eye casualty operating without a single doctor in the unit at a given time. The local leadership team in eye casualty was similarly supportive of staff development, but was restricted by persistent short staffing and lack of senior support. This is a very clear red flag, and you don't want to work in a place like this. Before I end this video, I thought I will mention my favorite hospitals. My favorite District General Hospital is St. Peter's in Surrey. I like working in District General Hospitals, and this is one of my dream hospitals. Hopefully, I will get to work there again someday. My favorite tertiary hospital is Nottingham City Hospital in Nottingham. That is all for my video today. I hope you found this useful. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel for more videos, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!